Get out of the military. First came under the God who is the head of my life, Pastor Alexander and First Lady Alexander. Ms. Johnson, deacons, mothers, members, and friends. Good afternoon. Y'all have been with my mom, bro. I stand before you on our youth day to introduce to you my very best friend, my sister in Christ, and my A1 since day one, Chelsea LaSara Smith. Before she was my best friend, she became the only daughter of Dana Smith and the only born granddaughter of Edith Smith. And she was the baby girl to complete a 5 generation of women in her family. Chelsea and I first met at Jerusalem, which is now Spirit of Excellence Christian School, at the age of 2, and haven't departed our friendship since. From there, we watched Chelsea grow into the amazing, confident young lady that we all know her as. Amen. Chelsea graduated from Noonan High School this past May with honors. Following high school, my sister will make her transition as a college student at Clark Atlanta University with a major of chemistry and hopes to become a pediatric dentist. Because we are such great friends, we share many memories and similar interests like praise dancing, talking a lot, and making each other laugh. And those are just a few of our countless memories together. But words cannot express how proud I am of my best friend and all of her amazing accomplishments and how she conquered all of her challenges that were thrown against her to get her where she is today. As I come to an end of telling you just a few more facts about how wonderful my best friend is, I just want to say that I love this girl like a true sister since we both are the only kids to our parents. Without further ado, I give to you the speaker of this youth day, my sister and best friend, Chelsea LaSara Smith. You got this, girl, because you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you.
Gracious Father, I come to you as humble as I know how. On this day, we are celebrating the youth here at Zion Hill. I ask that as I prepare my mind, body, and soul to give your people just a word of insight, that I receive your anointing that breaks and destroys every yoke of bondage. Lord, I thank you for giving me the grace to stand firm until my speech is complete. I also pray that God is shown through me and not let them see me, but see you in me. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. I stand before you today as your 2015 Youth Day speaker. Will you all turn to your tablets, iPods, tablets, whatever you may have, or if you have your Bibles, would you please turn to me to Job chapter 32, verse 1. Would you please stand in the reverence of the Lord? Job chapter 32, verse 1. Let me know when you have it. Say amen.
Amen.
These three men stopped trying to answer Job because he was so sure he was right. But Elihu, son of Berechiah, the Buzite, from the family of Ram, became very angry with Job, because Job claimed he was right instead of God. Elihu was also angry with Job's three friends, who had no answer to show that Job was wrong, yet continued to blame him. Elihu had waited before speaking to Job because the three friends were older than he was. But when Elihu saw that the three men had nothing more to say, he became very angry. So when Elihu, son of Berechiah, the Buzite, said this, I am young and you are old. This is why I was afraid to tell you what I know. I thought older people should speak and those who have lived many years should teach wisdom. But it is the spirit in a person, the breath of the Almighty, that gives understanding. It is not just older people who are wise. Let me say that again. But it is the spirit in a person, the breath of the Almighty, that gives understanding. It is not just older people who are wise. They are not the only ones who understand what is right. You may have a seat. If I could give you a title today, it would be, What Are You? Not what are you, but what are you? According to Merriam-Webster Dictionary, it defines youth as the time of life when someone is young. But on today, I'm going to give you three biblical points that I pulled from the Bible that describes the youth and that stood out to me. Those three points are, what is God's purpose of youth? God uses you to work for him. And how can you make an impact on today? My first point is, what is your purpose? Everyone is struggling with their purpose in life, whether it is how you fit into society, where you fit in spiritually. But as youth, we already have a frustrating time in life, because we're yet to find who we are, our own selves. Yet, then again, we're trying to figure out how we fit into society. Where are we going? Then we're also trying to figure out how do we fit in spiritually? When is God going to tell me to do something for him? It is also the period of time where we are feeling independent, and we want to deter from our parents' ways and think that we may be grown in several circumstances. But yet we are still having to be dependent upon our parents.
Amen.
God has endowed each and every last one of us with a gift, a talent, or an anointing. However you may take it, we all have a gift that God has given us. It may come through the ministry of dance, may come through the ministry of song, it may come through the ministry of music or teaching or helping. However God has blessed you with that gift. But we all must take those gifts to magnify the name of Jesus and to uplift his kingdom. Otherwise, they're no good. But in order to find those talents, in order to find our gift, we must have and find our connection with God. And finding our connection with God, that means that we are working for Jesus. Going on to my second point. God can use a child as early as the child accepts them into their life. As long as God is obtaining the glory, age does not matter.
Yes.
Whether you're young or old, you still are able to give your life to God.
Right.
God used Elihu to encourage Job while he was in his youth. Three older men were talking to Job at that time, but Elihu let his age intimidate him for what God instructed him to do. So, please understand that God can use you no matter what your age, your gender, your ethnic culture, or your background.
Amen.
It does not matter.
Amen.
1 Timothy 4:12 says that we are instructed by Timothy to let no one despise your youth, but be an example to the believers in word, in conduct, in love, in spirit, in faith and in purity. With age comes the wisdom.
Amen.
And with wisdom, we all must go through a mess to obtain the message.
That's good. That's good.
But as young people, we go through some messes too.
Amen.
We go through some challenges. And that therefore, we are able to have a message that might can help an older person.
Amen. Amen.
But yet, the Bible says that we must respect our elders. So therefore, we must know when, how, and where to voice our message.
Amen.
Moving on to my third point with how we voice our message as youth. Living in this society, as a 2015 generation, it is very hard for us to live young and live the life that we want to live as young people. But when we are living young and living for Christ, it's a whole nother story. Because we are special in God's eye.
Yeah. Yeah.
So therefore, we can't do what the world wants us to do.
Amen.
But we must go out into the world and be a vessel so that God can use us to minister to the world.
Amen.
The scripture represents youth in both a time of danger and of challenge. We are living in a dangerous society where we are constantly being attacked, especially the African American race.
Amen.
And as young men and women of God, we are even countering other challenges because we are being attacked just because of the color of our skin and who and how we can't even go in our own church and worship God. But Moses said in Genesis 8:21, the imagination of a man's heart is evil from his youth. Meaning that what we do in our youth, whether it's good or bad, will reflect back when we become adults.
Amen.
When we take over and we youth step up into our parents' and grandparents' shoes. So what we need to do today, youth, we need to stand up for what is right.
Yeah.
We need to give ourselves a message. Because what we go through on a daily basis can help our elders help us get through with our challenges so that we won't have to struggle the way that they do.
All right.
I encourage you to let your light shine in your everyday life, showing the world that the greater one lives in you, so that it will soon overtake and God will then become the source of all of our lives. Never change yourself for anyone, because God created you exactly how he wanted you to be. So you, all of our role models that we have, all of our celebrity idols, it's okay to have them. But yet we need to know that God and Jesus is our life role model and our only idol that we should love. And in those steps of life, God is going to help us. But here on this earth, we all had to have some help to learn how to speak the words that we speak today.
Yeah.
They're called alphabet. We call the ABCs. We all had to learn them, whether you're in preschool, kindergarten, whenever you learned them. We all had to learn them, right? Well, I'm going to give you the ABCs of life. These challenges as youth, they're not going to get easier. We're stepping up into the world. We are becoming adults. So therefore, we're going to be faced with challenges physically and spiritually. So we must remember these ABCs that I'm about to tell you. We must A, accept the challenge. With all of our struggles, youth, we are always trying to find who we are But first, we gotta accept the challenge of where we are. The B, we must believe in ourselves. And C, convert our hopes and dreams.
Yeah.
And D, have the determination to turn our dreams into a reality. Well, we've already accepted the challenge, so we have to have the determination to get through the challenge. We should E, expect some obstacles on the way up.
Yeah, right now.
Those challenges, they're not gonna be easy. They're gonna have some obstacles. This is gonna be some things that's going to obstruct us from accepting that challenge.
Yeah.
So therefore, we must be ready to expect it.
Yeah.
Right.
And L, we should fight while being faithful and finishing the course.
Yeah.
We should G, get Jesus on our side, because without God, we will not fail.
All right.
And H, have a Harvey model of leadership.
Yes.
We should I, inspire someone else, whether it's with a smile, a hey, how you doing, or a hug. It might inspire someone else. And J, take Jesus on our journey. We should K, keep on keeping on. And L, step up and be a leader. Step up to the plate, be a leader. We should M, make every day count. And N, never give up. We must overcome our obstacles.
Yes.
Those obstacles that we expected, we've all got to overcome them.
Yes.
And P, put our best foot forward. We must Q, quit quitting. And R, run the race with patience. We should S, strive on while trusting in the Lord. My grandmothers used to tell me, just trust in the Lord and He will direct your path. We should use our talent. And D, value our time. Because you will never know when it's your last time on this earth. We should W, wait for understanding. And X-ray our own lifestyle. Because we all skeletons in the closet. We should Y, you are to achieve all that we seek. And Z, be zealous while reaching the top. We must all put God in first in everything that we do. So in my conclusion, I want you all to be reminded that young people are wise too. Thank you.